Tell we should of waters dark and visions bright in their reflection, of a modern font which stands a miracle of art's confection, how its poise and stillness call the mind to matters spiritual, how the smoothest filaments of flowing water speak renewal. Now, in course, the pictorial arts have always had a place in the church, right from the early Saxon times, and the wonderful statues in the portals of the French cathedrals, or in the stained glass pictures of the Gothic period. And though the Reformation brought a period of Puritanism into matters, so that stained glass were smashed and statues had their noses and halos knocked off, depictions in stone or glass have always been important in the telling of the stories of the saints and the Bible, right up to current days. Memorials have been couched in artistic settings, or reflect the oeuvre of the day, if I said that right. Most churches have some interesting memorials in them, which be worth the seeking on them out. And so it were perfectly natural that cathedrals and girt churches, who receives lots of visitors, have got in the habit of hosting or commissioning works of modern art. Modern art, though. Oh. Now, I'm not old-fashioned, rarely I'm not, but I knows what I likes well enough. Show me a picture of a nice scene of nature, or a portrait as in person, that's right enough. But I went to some art display once called a installation, and it were a series of packing cases filled to the brim with little balls of polystyrene, and a TV screen with some bloke blathering away strange-like. Now I ask thee, who are they charlatans who masquerades as artists, rarely? The latest century have certainly been responsible for some travesties of so-called modern art. But at the same time, there have been people finding the right measure and proportion in their particular ways, like thick Sophie Ryder and her strange critters looking at each other, or Richard Long and his girt creations in slate stones. Indeed, one of the cathedral's recent masons, Jay Battle, who carved a series of new statues for the waste front of the cathedral, now makes commercial works of sculpture in stone. Howsomdever, I be getting beyond the point. And that is that, strange to tell, Salisbury Cathedral seems to have never had a permanent font. Certainly they's never had girt demand for baptizing, since the city church of St. Thomas would probably serve such needs anyway. But I guess as there be cathedral weddings and cathedral funeral and memorial services, they bethought themselves to commission a font in the modern art vogue. In course, if they had gone into it the wrong way, it might have been disastrous. But Dean June Osborne, then the canon treasurer, started off that project in 2008. They set into work with a man called William Pye, a sculptor who had more and more started to use moving water, fastening on to a fascination with manipulating the hydrostatic properties. See, they wanted to create a centrepiece for the western end of the nave, just opposite the walled north porch doorways, something that would catch the eyes of the thousands of visitors, and so he come up with one of the schemes he already knew on, what he called his brimming bowl series, in which a girt dark bowl holds the water, which is seemingly mill pond still and serene, so's you can see reflections of the surrounding architecture all over the shop. If you have ever been to Mottisfont Abbey near Romsey, the original font or fount be still there in the garden, a round 12 feet deep pool which looks still as a looking glass, though it shifts a flow of water down a little stream nearby. Mr. Pye's brimming bowl is the same principle. It be shaped like a cross, and seems so still that the reflections of the cathedral roofs and pillars be just like one of they girt table mirrors you might see in other cathedrals, to help you look up over your head. And yet, at the same time, the water is actually flowing in smooth filaments from each little corner of thick font, to arch down to the floor into a bronze grating, where it be pumped back in. A piece of modern art though it be, thick font is a glory and a wonder, providing a marvellous eye-catcher and light-catcher in the hushed environment of the cathedral nave, a dark vessel of stillness, in which yet the water flows in they spouts at each corner, a reflection on the stillness of contemplation and the powerful renewing energy of life. A thing of beauty it is for sure, and a real certain highlight for all the visitors.